Well, hi there. It's the same old workshop as always, but something has changed. This channel has gone into four-digit territory, subscriber-wise. What can I say but thank you? I'm absolutely humbled. It's incredible. I would have never thought when I started 11 years ago that I would ever reach 1,000 subscribers. That's, you know, I mean, compared to other channels, that's not a lot, but it's a lot to me. I mean, it proves that people are interested in what I do, and it's not just me that likes doing this kind of stuff. And there's nothing more enjoyable than to read the comments after having successfully completed a project, no matter how useless it might be. It's one thing, of course, making it is a lot of fun. I wouldn't do it if it wasn't fun. But then there's the complete other part where you see that other people appreciate it, and a lot of people do. And that's very reassuring. So yeah, that's basically what I want to say in the introduction here. Thank you. Thank you very much for doing this and for supporting me. Words can be very pleasing to read and very humbling to see how people appreciate what I'm doing. Basically, this video is just going to be like any old regular other video, so let's get right to it. Those of you that have been following this channel for, I'd say, at least 3 years know that I do not own a butane-driven blowtorch anymore. I own these guys, which are all petrol-powered. This one was my first one. I actually had to make the entire T-valve here new because the old one was clogged up. The newly made valve is okay, I mean it works fine, but the flame heat of this thing dies down pretty quickly. You can pump it up to power and then have a very hot flame, but that will diminish over time. You know, it doesn't take longer than maybe 20 to 30 seconds and the flame is back to a very dim blue again, which is fine for soft soldering, but don't try silver soldering with this thing, it's just a nuisance. So I bought this guy here, which is a Hähnel, pre-war actually, and it's a very hot torch. It's very good for silver soldering. The problem I have with this one is that it's angled upwards, so it's fine for certain jobs which are this tall. But for any other job, you would have to keep holding it downwards like this just to get the part hot, which can also be quite a nuisance over time. None of you have seen this little guy here. This is a very recent addition. I got this one for free actually from a good friend. And this is a very nice small torch which is up to heat very quickly. And it can be used on any kind of smaller job, like soldering two pieces of sheet metal together. And it's actually very nice to work with when you don't have one to take the time and power the big guys up. So, since I do quite a lot of silver soldering, I'm going to try and improve this blowtorch. Valve. It works just like any old drain cog. Basically, you have a tapered seat right here on the stem, and you just screw this into another tapered seat, and that's going to seal off a cross hole, and the gasoline would no longer be able to do this right angle path into the nozzle. What I plan to do is going to be a bit of a butchery, I'm afraid. You can see the threads for the nozzle here, the tapered valve seat right here, the cross-drilled hole in order to let the gases pass to the nozzle, the thread for the valve stem, and the sealing part where the gland packing is fitted into. Step one is going to be to drill the whole lot out. You can see a cylindrical part right here, the chamber where the gases can accumulate and whirl around, and a registering diameter for the insert. I will also plug the hole off, which is right here, and re-drill it further over here so the gases have a longer way to go and thereby have a lot more chance to carburate. This is the insert. You can see the inside is exactly the same as the valve currently is. You can also see the hole is now drilled on top so that the gas has to pass around here and not can just go the straight way. I plan, or I hope, this is going to give it more swirling action and thereby more efficient carburation. We'll see how that goes. You can see the 15mm diameter here for registering purposes and the 9mm diameter here, which is going to slide in to this portion. The assembled unit is then going to look something like this. You can see the hole re-drilled further on the right. You can see the hole of the insert part over here. So the gases have to go all the way around in the chamber, swirl around nicely, and then we have a soldering area here and a soldering area here where the insert is going to be sealed off against the body.
A bowl of cherries, don't be so serious, life's too mysterious. You work, you save, you worry so, but you can't take your dough when you go, go, go. So keep repeating, it's the berries, the strongest oak must fall. The sweet things in life, to you were just loans, so how can you lose what you've never owned? Life is just a bowl of cherries, so live and laugh at it all. Thank you.
those happy feet, give them a low-down beat, and they begin dancing. I've got those 10 little tapping toes, and when they hear a tune, I can't control a dancing tune to save my soul. Weary blues can't get into my shoes, because my shoes refuse to ever grow weary. I keep cheerful on an earful of music free, 'cause I've got half, half, happy feet.
Certainly got a lot hotter, and it's also easily able to maintain the flame, and it's actually getting quite scary as soon as you pump it up to something. It's not going to maintain a extremely hot flame like this one did. You could see it glowing bright orange and have a huge flame where actually a light blue taper would emerge from the nozzle. That taper still stays inside here, but still, what I did to the valve actually really improved the machine, and I would say it's comfortably able to silver solder now. So, well, whenever I have a silver soldering job coming up, you will see this guy in action in order to prove what it's really worth. Well, that's that. There's my plan again. And see you next time. Thanks for watching.